Hello everyone, Koplan here again with the next video. As I said, I want to show some current matchups and I will show you my current deck first. Oh yeah, and I should probably switch to English. Okay, no, that didn't work. English. Ah, I need to open the deck again. Yeah. So. Okay. So here's what I'm currently running. One skilled rider, of course. Command Bridge. Remembrance Order. Void Engagement. Swift Strike. Goldstone Hunters. Informant Network. War Room. The Kumblei Bike Squad. Quick Reaction, Chroma Thunderhawk, Silverblade Landspeeder, the White Tiger Dao, the Anagar Veterans, One Dagotai Sacrifice, Storm Seers, two times, Stormlands, and yeah, I put in one Solvan, because yeah, in some situations which I will show you, might be useful to have a big frontline unit in the end, but I'm unsure about this. I think you can live without it. Yeah, the main idea with Jagatai Khan, of course, is to not have units on the field when your turn ends. That means so you can get his Reckoning cheaper, which is minus one cost whenever you control no troop at the end of your turn. And this is a little bit tricky because if it was you control no troop at the beginning of your turn, you could put some units on the field, knowing that your an enemy will probably remove it. This way you can't do that, and that also is the reason why I don't have Hakim or any other troop basically that could stick to the board. And yeah, you could add one of those because at 8 energy you will usually have your Reckoning already off, or at least can afford to do so. Yeah, I'm still experimenting. What I don't have yet is this one, which is yeah, not even a legendary, but still it wasn't in the shop yet, and I didn't get a single one in either the events or from the crates I bought, so yeah, I don't have it. Yeah. So basically, in my book, there are two ways to play the Khan. Either very light white on troops and tactic heavy to get the Reckoning off and do much of the dirty work with the Khan himself. Or you could, of course, do a standard troop deck, which you would usually do maybe with Quinxer instead. But his ability to gain sneak attack is still really cool. And with Skilled Rider and Tiger Dao, even without any other buffs, that's 5 times the possibility to do a sneak attack with 4 and act again. If you kill the troop, if you have the skilled rider. So you could decide to not go about the reckoning. I'm not sure, I will have to experiment with it more, but now let's show some footage. Yeah, the first one was pretty interesting. Computer. Okay. So I replace my wool hand because I don't need the troops at the beginning, and of course I always try to get my required legendaries.
Let's remain true today.
Of course, Vulcan or Salamander's General are always a pain to fight with the sticky troops, and especially if you don't have any board control yourself. It can get tricky. Also, you should also be aware that you need something to kill Vulcan in one turn when he got his reckoning off, and he will just keep cycling his reckoning and getting healed and getting another batch of survivor on top. So you should keep something in your hand to finish him off. Oh, look at that. Got my DAO now. Course, that was an unlucky pull because the cost reduction was just one now, but I spent 3 energy to draw it. But shit happens. Yeah, with Khan, you need to expect to get a lot of damage in the early game because before you got your reckoning off, it's really hard to keep the board clear, especially with Salamanders, and you are always at a 1 energy problem here. Lower energy starting, which is going to have yourself getting beaten pretty hard. So it's a good time to use the Stormlands to get rid of the Dreadnought. And you still have energy to get rid of his last troop, which means he won't get off his sacrifice. And yeah, I'm not attacking him. Oh, and look at that. This was really awesome because he can't play another tactic now. And yeah, so I think why not use it myself? Because the cleave damage will also help me getting rid of his troops. Oh yeah. I'm still not attacking him because he has the lead in health, and of course the Salamanders have a very strong late game. So I'm using the Reckoning now to heal and to get the free sneak attack now. Sacrificing one of the speeders. And now I can attack for free. At this point, the game is pretty much over actually because the survivor is not enough to save him. And yeah, when I play the Tiger down now, I have 7 attack in my turn. Don't get any retaliation damage, so I can just hammer them and use some units to get rid of his board presence. One damage satellite strike on one target is just fine for me. So the reason I like the bikes because 4-3 for that cost is pretty nice. Because I already got the reckoning off, I don't need to care about it sticking to the field. Yeah, this was actually an error for me because I could have played, of course, the seer earlier, would have been healed another time, but sometimes you realize what you want to play after you already took some action. really wants to get rid of it. Okay, so now it's basically over. Yeah. I had multiple ways to beat him now, with the fast units on hand, but this will suffice. Got his survivor off and bam. Good game. Okay, so next one is versus Voldo one. Is it just me, or does it happen like most of the time? I put a card away and I immediately get it again. Whatever. Okay, this is also a decent player. At least with a decent rating, so I suppose he has the cards he needs for his deck. Showing footage versus people without cards is of course not so interesting. Yeah. Yeah, and the early game is really slow because of the energy disparity. And especially if he doesn't play troops, it's always a question, should you play already some troops that die the turn you play them to deal some damage? In this case, of course, it's not a good idea, because it's always a good idea to have something to kill the drop pod. So, here I felt forced to use the Goldstone Hunters, which of course meant that my Reckoning didn't drop, and yeah, the Angel's Tears is just, in my book, one of the best cards of the Blood Angels. Really flexible, really powerful. Of course it has to die. I copied my skilled rider, which doesn't bother me because I usually don't have units on the field, so I don't care. Don't know why he copied that, he could have waited for the white tiger Dao. So I'm just trying to not have those troops get too strong. So I'm wasting a lot of energy just to get the drop pod away. Oh god. So, yeah. Can at least remove that. And now I'm in for a beating. He's probably feeling really confident right now. But with white scars you can really swing the state of the game. First get rid of this. And thanks to my Battle Honor ability I can clear the board. Yeah, and now I can trigger the Reckoning next turn. I And he didn't play any troops. Perfect time for reckoning. Free heal and free damage.
This is a place of honor.
And now suddenly the game swing into my direction. I'm in lead in health, got sneak attack, and even though he stunned me now, I can now play freely troops to stay alive. That didn't help him. And he's really getting low on cards now. And he knew it was over now. So. Yes, I will show two curse games now. One I won, the other I lost. They play completely different. So 2500, entry level of terror. And much like when you play versus Angron with the Khan, Angron attacks you, you get 3 damage, he gets 2 in return. Next turn you do a sneak attack, he gets 2 damage, you get 0. So in the end, just by bashing at each other, the Khan wins. And with all the other units you have in your deck versus his speeders and his Goldstone Hunters, it's pretty even. So I think the Khan is a good matchup to beat Angron. For Curse, it's similar because he can reduce your attack if you if he wants to 0 and attack you, and you can attack back for free. But then, if he gets off his Batman mode, he has sneak attack just like you, but he won't go to stealth because you will not play any units and you don't need many units on the field. So you don't even need to hurry to get him down to 0 health before turn 10. It won't work most of the time anyway, because yeah, you are not so quick. Yeah, as long as he doesn't play any serious threat, you don't really need to do anything. Of course it hit me, but whatever. Dealing another 2 damage. There you go. And we will basically be able to get the reckoning off at the same time if we want. I could have used the Thunderhawk, but I'm waiting, in this case, was fearing the Raven or one of those dreadnoughts that give counter tick. Need to get rid of my of some cards from my hand now. Yeah, so here goes Bitman now. So it's a good time to get him out of stats, so I can attack. But doing it after reckoning, so I get the sneak attack for free too. And now he's in trouble.
I deny you.
Lucky. Better. No, of course. Actually over already. I could have killed him with the two Thunderhawks in one attack, but I was thinking let's have some more fun with him. And he knows it. Just for fun. Okay, so that was really an easy game, but now you will see the other side of the table. Because there's a higher rated player, and I don't know in the last game whether the curse didn't get his legendaries out or if it doesn't even have them. This guy has them and is also running probably one of the cheesiest combos in the game. You will probably guess what I mean, but we will see. I should have maybe become suspicious because all of his card drawing he made. But I mean, Abandoned Supplies and Divinatators are common cards in many decks. And card draw is always important. Also, Asteroid Belt in a curse deck is not uncommon to get to Batman mode earlier. Yeah, still, if I had guessed what he is going to do, I would have saved a quick reaction. That would maybe have saved me. Problem is, because he didn't play any units himself, I was also becoming heavy on cards. So I had to play stuff and and he didn't give me any targets, for instance, for the Stormlands. So, yeah. It's really nothing. Yeah. Should have played a unit probably, but. So I'm playing quick reaction. Do I have a card less? Of course I draw a card and there's also problems, so I should have done this a turn earlier probably. He's drawing even more cards. He's really trying to deplete his deck. Seven cards, now 16. So if you see this, you really need to be careful. Best thing would be if you are offensive of war to have a pirate raid ready. I'm taking some mercy and forgiveness because Bloodthirst is nice. And shouldn't have played this, should have probably played the Informant Network. Because the Precog could have saved me. Pulling the tiger now. It isn't. Still not didn't use Batman mode. Now he's actually playing a unit. And now he basically has me where he wants. Because three cards left, and he basically has his whole deck in the hand now.
This is a place of honor.
And now it's over because he has one card left in the deck. Guess what he's doing? One willing side to play Warp Retreat after playing the Raven. And of course 50% chance to play the Raven again. Or to draw it again and then play it for free. So in hindsight, the quick reaction could have been a good way to avoid being hit by the Raven, But yeah, if you are forced to use it prior to that, then yeah, you have an issue. And that's even the that guy. I'm pretty sure he has a way to remove it quite easily, either with his warlord who attacks on the warlord, and where is it? Either Spectre of Judgment you could have used, not in that turn, of course, where he played the Raven, but one turn later, or yeah, Talent for Murder, for instance. Yeah. So it's Night Lords have decent options for hard removal, and yeah, I'm unsure if that is really helpful. On the other side, I think the combination of an 8-8 fast unit with a cycle card from Chaos, Warp Retreat, yeah. Of course, he needs the energy refill, but he draws it and can play it again, so it's 16 damage for 9 cost, basically, which you can't prevent. So, pretty powerful combo, and even if you would have him draw some cards himself with Lectizia Divina, Nut-Tatters or something, yeah, he would get some ping damage, but with all the healing he had in the deck, really not a problem. I think his deck is not really working well with high aggro deck. Angron, for instance, doesn't care, it will be over until turn 9. I think, I don't know, was it Skafti or Kazrim showed an Ultramarine deck with Ventanos, where he bet course prior to turn 10, so it's 10 energy turn, so yeah. But anyway, you can't have a deck that beats everything every time. And yeah, maybe another Apotheosis would be okay, but it's really yeah, very expensive card. And yeah, I don't even know if I really need the Storm Seer's Wisdom, wherever it is. Also, yeah, of course. I don't have it, so I don't see it. Good part here is the healing, which helps, of course, compensating some of the damage you will get in the early game. But sometimes, really, the hand is clogging with cards, and if he doesn't play units that you need to remove, it's really difficult. I might, yeah, could argue. Remove some troops and have more tactics, but then the chances are lower to get the two tactics you really want with War Room and Command Bridge to get the White Tiger and the Skilled Rider. So, more tactics, I don't know. Yeah, maybe one of you have a better deck, maybe you can share your strategy. Maybe someone of you tried really a troop-based Khan deck, which in my book can work too. And yeah, think still it's interesting faction, interesting warlord, you can have a lot of fun with him. And yeah, I think there's still a lot to learn and discover with these guys. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed the game. My next video, don't know. I'm in vacation starting next week or the week after. So I don't know if we'll have the chance to do another video. But it will be probably about my Sanguinus deck, I think. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so that's it for now. Have fun. New month started, so there's a new season. Ladder is not too high yet. You'll probably face dozens and hundreds of Angorns and maybe Urns and Kabandas. But yeah, it will settle down and then time to play more. Yeah. So, have a good one and goodbye.